Right, everyone see, yesterday where I am going to stop is the ninth problem. I am going to start the ninth problem. Everyone see, ninth problem is, once again I am going to explain ninth problem. So that is I am stopping problem. Probability 2 by 11 is the probability of an event. What is the probability of event? Not A. That means probability of A is given, that is equal to 2 by 11. Probability of not A is required. A dash is required. This is the probability. What is the formula in probability? Is probability of element plus probability of itself, not itself, is equal to 1. Probability of not itself is equal to 1. Okay, now substitute P of A value is a 2 by 11 plus probability of not A is equal to 1. Everyone simplify. Then we get the probability of A dash is equal to 1 minus 2 by 11. By the simplification, answer is 9 by 11. Right, everyone go through the 10th problem. What is the 10th problem is, everyone see, a letter is chosen at random from the word assassination. So first I will write word. What is the word? Is assassination. A S S A S S assassination. I N A T I O N, assassination. Okay. So 10th problem is, a letter is chosen at random from the word assassination. Find the probability of the letter. One probability of the letter is required. What is the, what letter is required? A vowel. First vowel C is write down. How many vowels are there? So A is a one vowel, again A is a one vowel, again A is a one vowel. So A, A, and A. Next one is, what is the, another one is the I is the one, two vowels, I is the vowels. Next O is the vowel. So how many vowels are there? Six vowels are there. Total is the six, but three are repeated, two are repeated. Okay. Next, consonant C is write down. Consonant C is remaining. S, 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 N, T, T, N. Okay, now consonant C is S, S, 4S, N, N, 4S, N, N, T. Okay, now N, N, T. So consonants are, how many consonants are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 consonants are there. Seven consonants are there. Okay. What is the asking the question is, first bit is one vowel is selection. Probability definition is favorable, number of favorable, six are favorable. In that one, one is selection, 6C1. Okay, na? By total is the 6 plus 7, 13C1. Okay, na? Next, second bit is, everyone observe, what is the second bit is, consonant selection. So here is the probability of consonant. So selection, how many consonants are there? 7, one consonant is selection. Total is the letter 13C1. Here is the vowel. Here is the vowel. One time C. Here is, I will write vowel. So probability of vowel V, I will write probability of vowels. Vowels are 6. One is total is the 13C1 by the combination. Okay, na? It is clear, everyone? Right. I go through the 11th problem. I go through the 11th problem. Everyone see the 11th problem. First read. Everyone read the 11th problem. Everyone read the 11th problem. Right. See the 11th problem. In a lottery, a person chooses 6 different natural numbers at random from 1 to 20. So, and if 6 numbers are matched with the 6 numbers already fixed by the lottery committee, he wins the prize. What is the probability of winning the prize in the game? Hint is, order of the numbers are not important. Okay. So this problem, I am going to work out this problem is, everyone observe, first in lottery, we have 20 numbers. First I will write in lottery. So 20 numbers is there. 1, 2, 3, ... 20 numbers is there. Okay, na? In this lottery, we are going to select 6 numbers. 6 numbers is required out of 20. 6 numbers is required. Point is understanding, na? Out of 20, 20C1 is the total 60C. So here out of 26 numbers, we are going to select. Okay, na? Next, what is given? Committee has 66 numbers are selection. Okay. Committee. Okay. Committee has specifically 6 numbers is fixed. So committee, what they did is committee has fixed 6 numbers. Fixed 6 numbers. So that 6 numbers, what are the 6 numbers? We don't know. I am letting the 6 numbers are 21 number, 71 number, 91 number, 111 number, 131 number, and 171 number. I am taking, actually they are not fixed, but I am fixing this number. If we are out of 20, I will take these 6 numbers. It is matched with the committee numbers fixed. Committee number fixed numbers. This is I am assuming. Everyone see, this is I am assuming. Actually, that numbers are not given. I am taking. So for our understanding only, this point is understand everyone. For our understand, I am taking that numbers. Actually, that numbers is not given. I am taking for our understanding. From 1 to 20, I take 2 number, I take 7 number, I take 9 number, I take 11 number, I take 13 number, and I take 17 number at a time. 6 numbers at a time I will take. Then game is over. I win the prize. So win the prize, I will write here. When I win the prize mean the same numbers is came. Then I will, at a time, 6 numbers I will take. Okay, na? So now you can see total number of ways select 6 numbers out of 20 numbers. 20 numbers is given, out of 20 numbers. What is the selection is 20C6. 20C6 means 20 factorial difference. 20 minus 6 is a 14 factorial and 6 factorial. And so 14 factorial is cancelled. 1 to 14 and 15, 16, 17, and 18, 19, 20, 19 and 20 by 14 factorial and 6 factorial. 6 factorial means write down. 5 factorial is 120, 720. Okay, na? 720. Now, so 14 factorial cancel and everyone find out by the calculator we get 38,760 is the value. This is the total value selecting the 6 numbers. But we take the 6 numbers at a time. Na? At a time is 6 lotteries I will take at a time. They are matching with this one. Only one only one game will be matching with all the numbers. Only one game, only one person, only one person. Only one person, you should understand, only one person, here is, understand, only one person will match the all the numbers. Only one person only match the all the numbers. Therefore, probability of winning is only one person match with all the numbers by total arrangement, either 3, 8, 7, 6, 0. Okay, na? So this is the problem we are going to work out. Only one person will match the all the problems. Okay, na? Will match the all the problem by total. I will write favorable is the only one person because of number of persons never get. So only one person will get all the numbers will be matching. All the numbers will be matching with one person only by total. I will write. Okay, na? That is the problem. Right, everyone read the 12th problem. First read the 12th problem, everyone. First read everyone 12th problem. What is that? Check whether the following probabilities of PA, PB are consistently defined. So here is the 2 bits is given. Consistently defined is given. Everyone see. I am going to work out 20th problem. Everyone see the 20th problem. Right. Everyone see 12th problem. 12th problem is, check whether the following probabilities of PA, PB are consistently, consistently means valid or not valid. First writer, consistent, consistent, consistency. Consistency means we have the two answers. One is a valid, another one is a not valid. Not valid. That is the we are going to tell. Consistence means that is the answer. That means PA, PB, and what is the given first bit? Everyone observe the first bit. I'm going to write here first bit. What is the given first bit is? Everyone observe. So PA, the what we are going to consistent, we tell PA, PB are consistent or not consistent. PA, PB are consistent or not valid or not valid. That is the point we are going to observe here. Okay, na? So PA, PB consistency mean PA, PB valid or not valid. Okay, na? Valid or not valid, we are going to check. Okay. First bit is, everyone see, P of A is equal to 0.5. P of B is equal to 0.7. P of A intersection B is equal to 0.6. First, everyone draw the Venn diagram. First, I will draw the Venn diagram. First, see. This is the A and this is the B. This is the B, this is the A, okay, na? This is the A. A is the 0.5, this is the A, total A is the 0.5, but A intersection B is the 0.6, common is the 0.6, it is the highly impossible, okay, na? A is the 0.5 only, but common is how it is 0.6, not possible, na? A only 0.5. Okay, na? So that means P of A always greater than P of B, then only valid. Then only valid. P of A, here P of A is less than P of A intersection B. So valid for this one. This condition is valid. But in this problem is P of A is less than P of A intersection B. Therefore, not valid. P of A is not valid. What about P of B? See everyone, what about P of B? What about the P of B? P of B is where we have? Right. P of B, see, P of B value is, P of B value is, P of B value is, what is the P of B value? P of B value is 0.7, but P of A intersection B value is 0.6. P of B is greater than intersection, therefore valid. Therefore valid. Okay, na? So Venn diagram we can see intersection is always smaller than the P of A and smaller than the P of B. That is the main point. Intersection is the common. Common is always less than or equal to P of A or less than P of A. But here is a greater than P of A, not valid. Okay, na? Greater than P of A is not valid. Here is write down. P of A is equal to 0.5. But P of A intersection B is equal to 0.6. It is impossible. Common is equal to P of A, but not greater than P of A. Therefore, fail. P of A is not valid, but P of B is valid. Now write down. P of A, not valid. Not valid, but P of B is valid. P of B is valid. Okay, na? Right. Everyone go through the second bit. What is the second bit is? 12th problem, second bit. Here P of A is given. P of B is given. P of A union B is given. P of A union B is given. Everyone go through the second bit. First, go through the second bit. Everyone observe second bit. Right, second bit is observed. What is the given second bit is P of A value is given by 0.5. Okay, P of B value is given by 0.4. Okay, next P of A union B is given by 0.8. Everyone see. Here you draw the figure. Everyone draw the figure. This is the P of A. This is the A. This is the B. A union B means non-common and common elements and B elements all are in the A union B. This is the A union B. Always A union B is greater than P of A and P of B. Okay, na? So because of A union B is the greatest. A union B is the greatest. Understand everyone? A union B is the greatest. Everyone observe. A union B is the greatest. A union B is the biggest set. So everyone observe. A union B means P of A union B is the greater than P of A and P of B. Okay, na? So therefore, P of A is less than P of A union B and P of B is less than P of A union B. Therefore, P of A and P of B both are valued. Are valued. Right. This is understand everyone. Right. Everyone go through the third bit. Everyone go through the 13th problem, filling the blanks in the following table. Right. I go through the 13th problem. Everyone see the 13th problem. 13th problem, everyone see. Filling the blanks. Everyone fast to do the 13th problem. Already you know that formula. Already you know the formula, 13th problem. So what is the formula is for the 13? So what is the given? Fill in the blanks first bit. P of A is given. P of B is given. P of A intersection B. And P of A union B. In these four, three are given. First bit is P of A is given by 1/3. P of B is given by 1/5. A intersection by 1/15. P of A union B is required. Immediately write down formula. P of A union B is equal to common P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Write down, find out P of A union B. P of A union B is equal to P of A value is 1/3 plus 1/5 minus 1/15. Take LCM and write down 5 plus 3 minus 1/15. Its answer is 7/15. First bit is completed. Right. Go through the second bit, everyone. Second bit. P of A is given 0.35. P of B is given, not given. Okay. P of A intersection B is a 0.25 and P of A union B is a 0.6. Immediately write down P of A union formula and work out P of A union B formula. P of A plus P of B is required. P of B is required minus P of A intersection B. P of A union B is a 0.6 is given. P of A is a 0.35. P of B is required. P of A intersection B is a minus 0.25. Only B, P of B leave it. Remaining bring on the left hand side. 0.6 plus 0.25 minus 0.35. Is equal to P of B. Is equal to P of B. So 0.6 plus 0.25, add 580, subtract with 35, 0.35. Then we get the answer is 0.5. Okay, 0.5. Hello. Ah, sir. Ah, tell me. Next, I will allow. Next, C. P of B value is 0.25. P of B value is equal to 0.5. Okay, na? P of B is equal to 0.5. P of B is equal to 0.5. Everyone go through the third bit. Everyone go through the third bit. What is the third bit is? P of A is given by 0.5. P of A is given by 0.5. P of B is given by. P PRB is given by, what is the PRB is given by? 0.35. PRA intersection B is required. PRA intersection B is required. PRA union B also given. What is the PRA union B? The 0.7. Write down the formula, fast workout. Everyone, fast workout. P of A union B is equal to P of A plus, fast everyone workout, plus P of B. Are 10 minutes only there. P of B minus P of A intersection B. Right, substitute and find out. P of A union B is a 0.7. P of A is 0.5. P of B is 0.35 minus P of A intersection B. First find out, everyone, P of A intersection B. Bring on the right, left hand side. 0.7 plus P of A intersection B is equal to 0.85. Subtract. P of A intersection B is equal to 0.85 minus 0.7. That is equal to 0.15. Right. Clear, everyone? Go through the 14th problem. First, we go through the 14th problem. Everyone go through the first 14th problem. Right, go through the 14th problem fast. Everyone see the 14th problem is, given P of A is 3/5, P of B is 1/5, find P of A or B if A and B are mutually exclusive events. P of A value is given. What is the P of A value is given by 3/5. P of B value also given. What is the given by P of B value is 1/5. Right. Find P of A or B. A or B. P of A or means union B. This is the required. And A and B are mutually, exclusive events. A, B are mutually, M-E-E, I'm writing, mutually exclusive events means P of A intersection B is equal to zero. No empty set. Then we say that mutually exclusive event. Now write down the P of A union B value and immediately substitute and find out P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Right. P of A union B is equal to P of A 3/5, P of B 1/5. P of A intersection B is a 0. Its answer is 4/5. Okay, na? Right. Everyone go through the 15th problem first. If E and F are the events, P of such that P of E is equal to 1/4, P of F is equal to 1/2, P of E and F is equal to 1/8, find out. Okay. P of E is given, P of E is given by, P of E is given by What is the P of E is given by 15th is the 1 by 4. P of F E is given by 1 by 2. Next, P of E and F. E and F is given by, what is the given by 1 by 8? That implies P of E and means intersection F is equal to 1 by 8. Okay, na? Right. Next one is, what is the required? First bit is P of E or F. P of E union F. Write down the formula. P of E plus P of F minus P of E intersection F. Write down values and find out what is the P of E value is a 1 by 4. P of F value is a 1 by 2. P of E intersection is a 1 by E. Total LCM is a 8. 2 plus 4 minus 1 by 8. That is a 5 by 8. Okay, na? Right. Go through the second bit, everyone. Second bit is, what is the second bit is? E, P of not E and not F. P of not E and not F. And not F. Carefully write down. P of not means E dash. Not means E dash. Okay, now second bit. Not E and not F. Right. Not means E dash. And means, what is the and value is given by intersection. And not F means F dash. Okay, na? Right. This can be written as reverse order. P of E union F whole dash. Okay, na? P of E union. So this can be written as dash mean 1 minus P of E union F. How it is? P of A plus P of A dash is equal to 1. P of A dash is equal to 1 minus P of A. Okay, na? So this is the total is the A dash. Total E union F is the A dash. Total is the A dash means 1 minus P of A. Okay, na? 1 minus P of A. E union F. Total is take it as a, consider as a in our mind. A dash. A dash means 1 minus P of A. Now write down its value is 1 minus P of A union B value is a 5 by 6. Simplification 1 by 6 is the answer. Okay, clear everyone? Last 2 minutes is there. 16th problem. Everyone observe the 16th problem. Before 16th problem, I go through the set theory. De Morgan's law I will write. In set already I will explain De Morgan's law. Once again I am going to recollect here De Morgan's law. So everyone observe and note down that points. Hello. Ah, 5 by 8, yes. I will correct. Sorry, here is 5 by 8. Sorry, here is the 5 by 8. Here is the 5 by 8. 1 minute. Everyone observe. Here is the 5 by 8. Here also 5 by 8. Answer is 3 by 5. Everyone correct it. Right. Everyone go through the De Morgan's law. I will write in set theory. De Morgan's law I will write in set theory. Everyone note down. De Morgan's law. De Morgan law. Hello. Last one answer is 3/8.